Right, what are we doing? I'm not even gonna bother. Yeah, I'm not even gonna bother with the intro today because I probably screw it. I've already screwed it up. I wasn't even selected in the right window.
Okay.
So essentially, we're going through this and collecting everything. Yes. Without paying.
For the most part.
Yeah, without paying.
This is basically a let's play showing that Warframe does not have to be a pay-to-win game. Don't worry about that, you'll get that later on.
This is all stuff that I haven't seen before.
Now you can upgrade and stuff like that.
Now I can supply the operator with better modded firepower.
Oh, thank you.
Violation. Doors have been looted as well.
Just to get rid of.
We need to figure out what Captain Vor has done to you and stop him. But we'll need help. I found a communication segment we might salvage for
if
your ship.
If Ordis ever gets annoying, activate your navigation system. You can turn him off.
Yep, I've just turned all the chat off.
Ordis.
Oh, Ordis.
AI.
Nah, he'll probably just be a funny little comment thing that I can sarcastically remark to. Can I thank you? Jesus. Right, so what have we actually got?
MK1 Paris.
That one.
That's a crossbow. I'm not even gonna attempt to try to pronounce that.
And then there's that one.
Yep. Yeah, you can buy that.
None of these we can actually get at the moment.
Most of them, no, because you have to go and rank up other things.
Yeah.
However, if you go back to the crossbow, or the bow,
yep,
go all the way down, find the Zouge. It's in the Z's.
That one.
Yes. That I have a feeling you would like because it does the exact same thing as the bow and arrows, except you can get it up to 100% status effect or status chance, so you can proc status effects with every arrow.
I'm gonna pretend like that made any sort of sense to me.
Status. Basically what status chance does, if you have elements such as corrosive and, let's say, blast, you can proc both onto an enemy. They would take corrosive damage, and they would get knocked down because of the blast.
Oh, that's pretty sweet.
Mm-hmm. And every weapon actually has an element to it, meaning your Skana, it has one primary element, so it can either be slash, puncture, or impact.
Kidoki. I'm guessing the bows and arrows would probably be puncture.
Mm-mm. There's some puncture, there's some impact, and there's some, I believe there's one that does, slash.
Okay, I'm gonna guess that we're doing this one that's highlighted first.
Yep.
That seems to be the way of games. If it's
now,
highlighted, do it.
Now I should say that in order to get off this off Earth and move on to other areas. Different planets, you're gonna have to go and do the junction, which I'll talk about more once you get back to the star map.
One thing that I do need to turn on though, controls, where the bloody hell is it? I hate games that don't do this automatically. Where the hell is... No, not toggle spring.
This data vault is equipped with Shut a variety up. Of security measures. How you defeat those measures is up to you.
Oh, since I see Archwing at the bottom there, this is a warning for, actually a little heads up for, basically in the future, because you're going to have to do Archwing missions. Archwing, at least on the console version, which I play, now actually can trigger motion sickness, and my clan leader, who actually has motion sickness, cannot play the new Archwing missions. He can't play the new Archwing, he can't anything like that, so... because of the motion sickness.
So, something that I won't have to worry about, but watches might...
Yes. But, you don't have to crouch.
I know, I just like crouching because he walks funny. Look at that ass. I have to make it entertaining somehow. Plus, if I'm crouching, I can do that. Which makes things a lot faster. It's also probably a stupid idea, considering I'll probably bound into enemies. Like that dude over there, who's about to get an arrow in the head.
Yeah, see that, Oh, wait. Yeah,
Did I just miss something?
No.
Oh, okay.
One thing you need to do is when you unlock the section, the capability to have companions such as Kubros, Kavats, and Sentinels.
Mm-hmm.
I highly recommend that you go and get Carrier.
Okay, you are going to have to remind me of this when I get there, because I will probably forget this within 5 minutes. Vacuum.
Basically, it increases the range at which you automatically pick up items.
Where am I actually going? This way. Apparently, we're going to... Whoa! Hi. Okay, well, that was easy. What the... What did I do to him? You could have told me that this bow and arrow was completely overpowered.
It's not.
Well, at the moment it is.
You're using the MK1. You're using the Mark 1 bow. Mark 1 Paris, meaning that there's still a standard Paris you can get, which is better than that. And then there's Paris Prime, which is even better than that.
Yeah, I hear people... Ah, there he is. I see him. See, it's all well and good. I'm using a melee unit that's as ranged. Because I'm defiant and I like to do things differently. Donk.
Well, when you get to level 10, you get Excalibur's Exalted Blade.
Mm-hmm.
It's a melee that's ranged.
Wait, it's a... Say that again?
It's a melee weapon, technically, that's ranged.
Okay, so I did hear you right. How the fuck does that work?
I'm not going to explain it, and I'm not going to spoil it. You're going to have to find out on yourself.
God damn it. Oh, this looks like it's going to be fun.
You're nearing the console. Trigger the alarms now, and it will start destroying the data.
Shush.
I would not go through those alarms.
Yeah, I'm not trusting the water.
No, you can go in the water. Trust me.
Ooh.
Oh, this is a spy mission. Okay. Don't do that. You go up.
Okay. I know that I'm supposed to get in there, but how? Oh, am I gonna have to do some funky shit from that way?
Nope, you can go under that.
Oh, okay.
Just jump across the hole.
Now where?
Jump across.
Serious?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Off you go! There we go. Ah, here we go. Oh, this is not easy to do with a space bar.
Data extracted. They won't even know it's gone. The segment is yours. Head to extraction.
Yeah, you don't have to go looting if you don't want to.
I'm gonna anyway, because it probably helps.
It just gives you materials, mostly.
Where am I actually going?
You can go out.
So I should be able to go this way now.
Yeah, the door is open though, so you could have just...
I want to know what this green thing is, so...
That's extracting.
Oh, so I am actually heading the right way for once.
Hmm?
That's something new for me. I don't normally ever go the right way.
Watch out behind you.
God damn it, you're supposed to be helping me, not tricking me. Donk.
Hey, it's a video. You're supposed to make it fun.
True. I tried to make it fun. No, it's actually far too quiet. I'm lost. Which way am I going? This way, I think.
Mm-hmm.
How did he not see me?
AI in this game is retarded.
I'm gonna add blind to that list. Good God, how far is this? Aye. This map's a lot bigger than I thought it was. Get out of my way. Much faster. That felt way too easy. Why did that feel way too easy? Am I still in tutorial?
This is level one. No. You completed the tutorial, but... you basically did a level one mission.
Eh.
Oh, and, those three mods?
Yep.
Don't use them.
Don't use them. Okay.
Mm-hmm. They're cracked. Meaning they're broken.
And?
Orbiter void cloak engaged. You can max those out, welcome but back, the original ones, the unbroken ones, are a lot better. Meaning you get more bonuses out of it.
This technology is beyond the Grineer. It must be Corpus in origin.
Systems engaging. I suppose.
Go into the marketplace. I want to see something.
Ordis is grateful.
Tenno, the balance of power continues to shift.
Go to where it says home.
With new invasions.
Mm-hmm. Go down to equipment, I believe.
Contact black market scumbags. Contact arms dealers.
Color palettes.
What was that?
Go to color palettes.
Tenno, color palettes. We need to make contact with a corpus defector sympathetic to the Tenno cause. They will, of course, require compensation.
Click one.
Anyone?
What orders is referring anyone. To, operator?
Anyone.
In this case, compensation will not be credits. It will
you
be
can't
freedom.
Buy those, please.
I've updated navigation.
You
will need to break him out of a Grenier gulag.
For your login for the day, you got a 50% off coupon.
Well, for colors?
Mm-mm. Just next time you buy something with platinum.
Ah.
However, you're probably thinking, but I'm not spending a dime. That's true. But DE is nice enough and gave you 50 platinum.
Well, that's not 100% certain. We'll be doing most of this without spending anything, but I might pick up some extra colors just to make it look nicer.
Yeah.
But that's my own personal
preference. Besides the colors.
Yeah.
Besides the colors, you can get everything else in the game.
Yeah. Right, what are we doing now? Probably another mission, right?
Most likely. Okay.
Holy crap. Okay.
Before we go and do anything, see where it says the Venus and Mars junctions?
To Mars, says, yeah. See them? Or about them?
Look, go down one dot. No, go to where it says Venus junction.
Yeah, there.
No, that's to Venus, the one right below that.
Oh, that.
Yep. You need to... What you need to do is you need to do the junctions in order to get to new planets. And in order to do that, you need to go and do these prerequisites, like the complete the quest Forest Prize, which you're actually doing right now. Apply 4 mods to a single Warframe, which you can do in a little bit. Upgrade any mod to rank 2 or higher in the fusion process, which will do once you unlock the mod station, and defeat 3 Eximus enemies on Earth, which is going to be a pain to do.
Lovely, so I'm going to be stuck here for a little while.
Yep. Now, if we go up and do to the Mars Junction,
well, that looks this like it's going to be a lot easier.
However, you need to do the quest once awake. In order to do that, you have to go and do the Venus Junction.
Ah. God damn it.
Yeah.
At least I have a walking wiki. Walking talking wiki on my hands. So this is the next part, yeah?
Yep.
I take it, don't have to
be. It's that. Yeah, that, the sortie you cannot do today.
Yeah. Well, let's move straight onto this and... No, I don't want to wait for players. Go away. I'm happy doing it on my own.
There are some missions where...
I will need other people, I know, but... For the
moment... Well, you may want to have other people. You don't have to have them.
For the most part, I prefer to do it on my own. I don't like having to rely on others. Especially when they normally run off ahead and just leave you behind, or at least that's my previous experience with it.
Yep, that's exactly what people do. Then again, if I join in with randoms, I'm probably going to just go ahead and go and go straight for it. Whatever we're doing, I'm going to go straight for it. They can catch up if they want, but... go straight. Now, once you get to the end of the path over here, you have 2 options.
I think I remember this one.
How many Grenier slaves died?
Why are you down there?
I don't actually know. It started me down here, so...
Okay, so it looks like the 2 paths thing is... not able to be done. So you could just go one way.
Sympathetic toward the Tenno. The Grenier must have found out.
The Aspirus is working. Breaking through.
We go into the pipe.
I see the shadows of your mind.
Creepy bastard.
Don't let Vor distract you. Focus on the mission.
Just wait till he starts fucking with the shield.
What is that about my shield? I kinda need that.
Yeah, that thing that you have on your ankle, or that asterisk thing.
Yeah. Well, it's not even on my ankle, apparently it's on my shoulder.
Yeah, well, that thing, he's able to almost take control over your Warframe, and he starts fucking with the shield. Meaning he reduces the capacity by half.
Youch, that's not going to be very helpful. Doopy 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 doopy. Okay, that I'm glad that works in the same way that Skyrim does.
What do you mean?
If you press R while fully extend draw back, you cancel it. Okay. Again, really quiet. It's not makes for very entertainment. And apparently I can't English.
Yeah, you're English.
Oh, okay, there was a second guy there.
Yeah, I would not... trying to kill them as quickly as possible because they will turn the alarms on and that will just make things a little bit worse.
A little bit worse, so I get to fight and kill more people, yes?
Yes, but in this, you do not want alarms on.
Alright, any particular reason why?
You're doing a rescue. In a rescue, alarms go on, and you're trying to get to the hostage. They get put onto the execution table, and you have, like, a minute to get to them. And if you don't get to them in a minute, they die. You fail the mission, have to restart it.
Oh, yeah, okay. Kill them as quick as possible then. I'm actually surprised there's not more.
In the higher levels, areas, it will get harder. Like in the sortie, it goes from 60 to 100.
Oh shit, I don't think I killed that one.
This is the prison block. If you can avoid detection by the warden,
It
may be easier to get Darbo out. Bypass the security.
You go to one of the panels and hit to activate. Ooh.
Thank you. There we go.
Don't, no. Oh wait, yeah, that's a warden. You do not want to kill the warden or attack it because it has a lot of health and it's
probably gonna.
They will go to an alarm, and they will take probably half your ammo capacity before you can kill them.
Seeing as I don't particularly want to kill anyone just yet until I figure out where everyone is.
Well, if you can... The way I see it is if you can go rescue the hostage, you can go kill whoever you want.
Did I actually get him? No, I did not miss him. There we go. He is right in my way.
Yes. Go around and get to that turret. that's like right in the middle of the room, you can kill him with the turret.
Oh shit. There we go. That was fairly easy. Oh god. I'm not even close to done, am I? Okay, nothing in there.
Just be glad that there wasn't a infested prick in there. Yeah, Darvo, shut the fuck up.
Extraction is ready. Remember, your success here depends on getting Darvo out of there alive.
Well, I just hope to God he doesn't do that whole invisible wall thing that we had when I was playing on the PS4.
The Lotus must be desperate.
Basically, the way I see it is if you can run directly to the exit, and he'll catch up, and if he doesn't, then he, you can just say bye and kind of go to extraction and finish the mission even though he's not there.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's what I do in every,
Oh, fun.
Now, the Ascaris has burrowed deep enough to give me influence. Shall we see how your shields work?
Why is there infested stuff on the ground?
The Ascaris is letting Vore control your shield. We must figure out how to remove it. Avoid taking damage while I try and block him.
Avoid trying to take damage. Okay. So I immediately go in and take damage. I really don't know why I keep chopping these boxes, because I'm not actually getting anything useful out of them yet.
Credits.
Yeah, I suppose so. What the fuck happened to him?
Well, I want to know why there was a giant lag spike.
What do you mean, lag spike?
On my screen, you shot the arrow and then he just... like the whole game kind of just bugged out for a second.
The captive has been liberated. You will be rewarded for this, Tano.
Oh, okay.
See, continuity. You got all broken ones.
Yeah, I'm not exactly the luckiest person.
However, you did get a continuity and intensify, which is. Yeah, you can turn off that scanner if you want. To upgrade your arsenal. May I recommend fire? The thing, that orange thing right there.
Mm. What orange thing?
Look straight ahead. Yep. Look straight ahead.
That's the sun.
In front of you. That thing.
Oh, that. Okay,
It does absolutely nothing for you.
Okay. So why is it even there? I don't even know what it does, so...
Operator,
what?
The scanner.
Neither do I.
Upgrade your Warframe now.
Oh yeah,
To the arsenal to see the weapon upgrade options you have.
I guess since you have that thing, go put a couple mods onto your Warframe. Yes, I know they're broken, but they're better than nothing at the moment.
New arsenal features. It is for the operator's own good. An excellent find, operator. There are hundreds of these mods to locate.
Oh, I'll put that redirection on because it's
a lot of possibilities.
No, the other one.
Install the mod right above it. Before we can continue.
Yep. That's an unbroken or unbroken one.
I know if you match up the symbols as well, it costs less to put it in.
Mm-hmm. continuity and intensify.
So, one in there, and that one. Oh, I don't actually have enough room for that.
Oh. Yeah, that's right. I forgot that, your master rank, zero.
Yeah. Rub it in. Alright.
Well, the way it's set up now is that,
angry.
Like, after we played on the 4, the way it's set up now is that, when you get a new Warframe, new weapons, new anything,
I recognize that
the
it's a parasitic restraint. We corpus you some
mods
to keep our robotics in line.
The capacity that you get
so
is equal to the master rank you have.
Ah.
For free. Because I like you.
Now, if you have, say your mastery rank, 20. You have 20 capacity points. Now, if you have, if that Warframe or item has a reactor or, catalyst, which, you'll get some later on. They basically double the mod capacity, so that 20 goes into 40.
We must restore the ship's foundry immediately.
So you can almost, when Master Rank 30 becomes a thing on the consoles, you can have a unranked Warframe and have it basically maxed out rank mods. Meaning a rank 0 Warframe can have 60 capacity points.
Huh.
You just go to that blue dot that's blinking.
Tenno, we may have a problem. The colony is unresponsive. Get to the surface so we can see what's going on.
God damn it, did someone just join me?
Mm-hmm.
God damn it. It was gonna happen eventually. So I went really quiet in that last bit because I was trying to listen to you and then Aldous and just about everyone else decided they wanted to talk over you.
I find that Aldous I don't really pay attention to.
I was
to.
Afraid of this.
Wow,
the
you actually have a man.
And I cannot find any signs of living colonists.
Your
you still
friend
have a
that
job to do.
Decided to join you?
Yes, the mag unit.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
And Mag got a rework as well, meaning that she's no longer good for just, Corpus.
Oh, you bastard. Where'd you go?
He's supposed to go there. Right there.
I've got enough of this, we're going melee.
You're actually supposed to stay up top.
Oh. The greens fear you, but I will show them. Their love will return when I deliver you to them.
There you go, that's how you deal with that one.
Tenno, are you there? The signal cannot be boosting any further.
I wonder, does Warframe have partial controller,
I think so.
Because if so, you could try playing with a controller and...
Yeah, I may actually do that just because it... easier. Let's find out.
You're getting shot at.
Yeah, I know I'm getting shot at. Oh look, it does have controller support. Now I just have to figure out what all the bloody buttons are.
What controller are you using?
Xbox controller, obviously, because PS controllers aren't compatible.
You say that, and yet I was playing a game with you a while ago with a PS4 controller. Yeah. It's
not as sensitive as my... Yeah, I'm going back to my mouse because my mouse is more sensitive. But yeah, no. What is that? I got blown up, really? It's not the time to be sorting out wires. Oh my god. There's fucking...
I like how the random person just decided to say, fuck you.
Yep, and this is why I hate randomers.
They're actually going the wrong way anyway.
What, the randomer?
Yeah, because they went around and they jumped across.
How are you shooting me through that wall, you bastard? I don't have any power, are you serious? Why? Thank you. Much easier. Alright, where the fuck am I going? This way, I presume.
Mm-hmm.
And now the random is back. Well, thanks for your absolutely zero help.
At least go down the ramp.
Down the ramp?
The side ramp.
What?
Turn around.
Oh.
That ramp.
Yeah, go down the side ramp. What fucking side ramp?
The one you just passed.
Well, I know that now. I wonder. Oh, I'm a cheeky.
You could have just wall, jumped across.
Doors are locked. Time to break in.
Okay.
Override successful. Let's get going.
Yeah, see that, you saw that yellow, like, particle effect?
Yeah.
That was a puncture prop. That's what I was talking about earlier.
I really need to get myself a gun, because this bow's good and all, but it does not have any sort of rapid fire on it.
That's why I said get the zoosh. Because it's a automatic.
What am I thinking? I had an automatic, semi-automatic weapon the whole time.
It's auto.
Now pick it up.
I can guarantee that I can probably click faster than it's auto. Yep.
Yeah, just wait till you get
Oh, we're going this way.
Faster. You pick up the thing.
Good. Your ship is one step closer to completion.
Now I have to kill 37 enemies.
There's one more thing you need to do. Eliminate all Grenier and provide justice for the colonists.
Soon the worm will
use your and I will second ability.
My second ability?
Mm-hmm. Because you're able to. I believe it's radio blind. Bring you home.
Oh, okay, well, there's absolutely jack shit around here. What about this way? Anything interesting this way? Anyone? Anyone want to play? Aha!
Oh, and I have one thing to skip. That's radio blind.
Well, that was fun. I still think I'd prefer my first ability, though.
Radial javelin?
Yep. Ow! There we go.
Wait. How'd you get one of his third abilities? ideas.
Whatever that is.
Third, not his first.
Oh, third. There's 37 enemies in this place, really.
Yeah. But it's a lot easier than what I have to go through.
I'm gonna guess you probably have to go through about 100.
Breach complete. We're free to proceed.
One time I had close to 300.
There's absolutely no one back here at all.
Do you see any red dots to follow?
No, I'm just checking to make sure that there wasn't like one stray one left behind or something. Because I remember what this game's like, and it's love for just stray enemies that are in completely the wrong place. I just saw a red dot. Where the hell did it go?
Over where the mag is.
Ow. Shortcut. Why?
Did you keep hitting your head?
Yeah, apparently.
Remember when I said about that wall jumping thing?
Yeah.
You can get from one side to the other. Just alarm like successfully hitting three walls. That's it. To normal security levels.
Thank you. See, I don't think there is...
You don't think what?
Yeah, see, there is an enemy, but I can't see it. See enemy.
You have to go through the broken pipe thing.
What broken pipe?
The one that's not spinning.
Oh. Oh, I didn't know that.
And you did Tweedledum over there.
See, I have an excuse though. Okay, these throwing knives do not do a lot of damage.
They're secondary. Most secondaries don't do a lot of damage, except the Coal Star, Axe Drum, and the Lex. Well, Lex Prime. Granted, there are a few other ones that can do decent damage too, that I'm not listing because those are the weapons that I've listed I've actually used. Other ones that I missed, I have not used yet. You go straight, not through the pipe.
Despite
that. Not through the pipe.
Oh. I was gonna say. Oh, hi. Mm-hmm.
Oh, and.
Oh, okay, that was all of them.
When you said you can click faster than the auto. Yeah, I have a feeling that there's a couple mods that you put on that would do the exact opposite, where you would have to hold it down to do throw faster.
Oh no, I can actually, you know the holding down, you know there's actually a limit to that, and it's faster than what you can actually input the click commands. If I really, really wanted to, I myself couldn't actually click that fast. But I can do 100 clicks in 0.1 of a second. just by bringing up one piece of software and just turning it to kill.
Your foundry segment is ready for installation.
Only problem is that does literally just use the click button. It just inputs a click command, and I still have to do all the aiming and that. Also, once I start it, I can't stop it, which means if it's doing 100 clicks and a menu comes up or something, it will click whatever's in front of me 100 times. So it can backfire occasionally. I have done that before. That was interesting. Okay.
Foundry restored. Here, the operator will craft many powerful weapons and tools to exact revenge for dismantling me. To expand your arsenal. Oh no. Operator, our component storage has been looted as well.
You don't say.
Typical Corpus. Sure, the blueprint is free, but jack up the components. Operator, we will need resources in order to build the countermeasure.
Now I have to go deal with Corpus.
Fun. Before I do that, though, I am actually gonna...
I just received a very explicit message from your ship, Zevlon. Mm-hmm. If you're looking for resources, why didn't you just say so? I know just the place, but I demand an apology. My mother is no gymnast, and she would never eat those things.
You can go straight to... Operator, I am sorry.
Wow. You may want to get a new ship, Zevlon, when you can
get
afford
the MK1, Bratton.
That one seems glitched. I've marked your navigation with a place I know. It's good for resources, if you can stand the cold.
I suppose it might, although it's louder, it might actually be more useful.
If you really wanted to be stealth,
I'll save the stealth for the Loki unit, because that's what that's actually for.
Ivar is a lot better now. Or, yeah, Loki's... Yeah, Loki's no longer the best for stealth.
No, but it is a stealth unit, and it's one I prefer, so I don't care if she's better.
Ivar can stay invisible as long as she has energy. And you can make any weapon, secondary or primary weapon silent with, that one. There's suppress and there's hush. Put those on any non-silent weapon, primary and secondary. You can use any weapon with Ivar. Meaning, in other words, you can put hush on Tonkor. And then you can shoot it, you can use the Tonkor with Ivara, and the enemies won't give it give a fuck.
Which is why you're here. Technically this is stealing, but don't let that bother you.
Plus, she can now go through lasers in the void.
They sell anything to anyone. Don't get me wrong, I like...
You know that orange thing that you had to do in that spy mission?
Yeah.
She can go right through that and not have any negative effects.
You have murdered my sons and disgraced me before my queens. But soon, the Ascaris will complete its task and bring you to me.
Okay, I swear that thing was shining back there.
Good work, but you're not done yet.
Yeah, because of the crate.
It wouldn't let me open it though.
You break it open.
Oh, it's one of those ones.
Mm.
Wait. I presume we are supposed to be going towards these red target thingies.
Mm-hmm. Each one's a cache. So seeing as how I believe
keep moving, there is more here.
Cradle D over there is going towards one. Cradle Dumb is completely lost and doesn't know where the fuck to go.
Oh, okay, he's got that one. Fair enough. In the meantime...
Time for extraction tomorrow. We've got all you came for.
Take that thing out.
The Ascorus has reached your mind and rendered your lotus mute. You will return to me over your own free will.
Oh, God. I would be slowed, wouldn't I?
You hit a bomb that gave you, frost.
Nope. Oh, my fucking God. What way am I going? This way. Are they literally just running through all the enemies?
Yep.
Oh, I actually thought that was an enemy there. Donk. Well, that was way too fast. Ain't really good.
Are you complaining?
Huh?
Are you complaining?
Yes, I am. Ooh, fast hands.
That's really.
Moving the mouse out the window. That's never good, moving the mouse out the window.
Operator, are you alright?
Right.
This part of your journey is over.
You go over to yours.
I admire you for your struggle.
There we
but
go.
But now.
And would you look at that? You're almost, you can almost do Master Rank. One test.
Lotus, do something. Help the operator.
We Grineer are millions strong, but with a flaw, we are diseased.
You can rush it for zero platinum.
Sterile. But now, we have you!
Operator, do not abandon me again. Build the countermeasure.
I did this for my love, my queen.
Okay.
They will forgive my insubordination when I deliver you to them. Our love will be reborn as we feed on your divine blood.
There you go.
Our children.
Why is he still chatting?
Flourish without disease. And
is he the jackass?
At peace. Father, grandfather.
So you're gonna shut up anytime soon?
What do you think you're doing? What a waste.
Oh yeah, now you have to kill him.
Ted up. Good, you managed to disarm Boris Ascaris. I thought I lost you. Oh no, the Ascaris had a tampering failsafe. It's burrowed into you and armed itself. We'll need to find Vor before it detonates. Get to navigation.
Fun.
Boarding a Grineer ship to access their personnel records will be the fastest way to find Vor.
I know you got a headache, but...
Operator, what are you waiting for?
There we go.
Ordis assumes finding Vor implies violence?
And I'm going to guess probably this one.
Yep.
Hello, operator. May I suggest you access navigation and save your life? For my sake.
No. How about everyone shuts the hell up for a second? People, like, not stay quiet for more than 3 seconds in this game or something.
Pretty Pretty much.
Good God, so it's just permanent talking.
Pretty much.
The systems on this Grineer Galleon can be made compatible with your ship. Find and extract a navigation segment.
This way.
What?
Oh. I think I set off the alarms already.
You have murdered my sons and disgraced me before my queens. But soon, the Oscaris will complete
its cry me a river for fucking waste of space.
You're on the sensors now. You've been detected.
No, I want to reload. And that's not the right door either. Why do I keep going the wrong way?
Because you don't pay attention to the mini-map. You do know how to read the mini-map.
Ow.
We have what we... Wait. Tenno, coordinates in this nav segment put the galleon on a direct course to a convoy of colonists. You have a choice. You can extract now, or you can disable this galleon and save the colonists. Saving the colonists could jeopardize this mission. I recommend you head straight to extraction, but the choice is yours.
What's a little bit of extra mission gonna hurt?
The Ascaris failsafe is attacking your systems. Your shield capacity
reduce
has
shields.
Just been halved. You're wasting precious time, Tenno.
Yeah. Oh well. I doubt it's actually going to kill me, otherwise they wouldn't have put it in, would they?
You've reached the ship's power systems. Destroy the reactor.
I never really... when I did this, you still have a thing to do.
What?
You have to destroy the things on the side.
Ow! Oh, jeez. Okay, that would be why I died.
Mm-hmm.
Mine. Are there any other people around?
No.
Yeah. It's a shame I can't take that with. I am best aim.
That should take the pressure off the colonist ship, but you need to get out of there. Get to extraction before the reactor goes critical.
That's going to be a nightmare in this. Sound waves. I'll be able to find this bit nice and easy because there'll just be a huge peak. It doesn't mean you can keep doing it, jeez. You end up breaking my poor speakers. Either that or the viewers hearing. Actually, do it more! At least they won't have to listen to me. Wait, what bloody way am I going now? The wrong way, that's why.
You're gonna have to hack that terminal back there.
God damn it. Oh, right, is it?
It's on the ground.
I couldn't figure if it was higher or lower. No, it's lower.
Override complete. Move on.
Thank you. Oh, it was easy.
The colonist ship has escaped. I admire your noble intentions, Tenno, but you must survive for the future of the system.
Nope.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Endo's the new upgrading thing.
Oh, okay.
I think, go do me a favor and go down to the mods area.
That's this one.
Correct. And go to that redirection that...
This one? Or this one?
No, that one.
Okay.
Click it. Start fusing into mod.
What, this one?
Yep.
Okay. Now what?
Click the plus button. Another one. Another one. Okay, so that's actually pretty interesting how it was.
I'm completely lost.
Basically, they took out, I believe they took out the necessity for fusion cores.
Yeah.
So, basically, they're going to make upgrading mods a little bit easier. Meaning, if you wanted, say, a rank 5 redirection, you can get it to rank 5 right there. Without trying to guess how many fusion cores you need to put in.
Ah.
So, and that's why all the other mods are blurred out, because you can't click another mod to upgrade it, put that in. Now, if you want to keep it, click apply. If not, just hit cancel.
Do I even have enough for that? Well, I actually have enough for probably more.
Yeah, you have 180, which you're at your limit right now. That's your last one, so plus 4.
Alright, so that's the amount that I can... That's the maximum amount I can do.
Mm-hmm. However, remember that you still have another prerequisite where you need to put 4 mods onto a Warframe.
Well, the mods are interchangeable, aren't they, so...
All at once.
Huh?
The mods have to be on all at once.
I know, but that's what I mean. They're all interchangeable, though. Exactly. So if I upgrade that one,
see, you exceeded your limit.
There we go. And you'll see what I'm up to in a minute, because if I can swap them out, then that's not a problem, because all I do, wait, put that one in. Oh, wait. Yeah, so I can't put 4 in at the moment anyway, because I don't have enough.
Mm-hmm.
Where'd it go? There we go. Now I'm going to be less likely to actually go and get myself killed. And holy crap.
What?
You know, that's actually going to have to be it, because I can't upload videos any larger than this. It's at 1 hour 14, it's 10.8 gigabyte.
It's not 1 hour 14, it's 1 hour 5.
1 hour 5, same difference.
No. You added 10 extra minutes to it.
Stop. I know what I'm talking about. I can English properly.
Yeah, you can English properly, but you can't do math properly.
I can do math properly. 1 + 1 = 6. Anyway, so that's going to be it for this video, anyway. But this will definitely be carrying on, and probably for the same amount of time each time as well. I just won't be able to store the videos, because at 10.8 gigabyte, I'd have no hard drive space left. Are you going to say bye-bye? Oh, you still need to say bye to the viewers.